friend and you're not mine. This difference helps me cross the line. And every time I'm confronted, I'm unafflicted by my actions. He is the result of a gain. Victory at the cost of pain. Like a freight train, you're tied to the tracks. No way to escape, there's no coming back. You're in my way, and I haven't got the time today. Best you walk away, and if you fight another day. Nothing personal, I just don't care. Won't bother explaining, it goes nowhere. Just know tomorrow won't come if I end things today. Suffering is the result of a game. Victory at the cost of pain. Like a freight train, and you're tied to the tracks. No way to escape, there's no coming back. You're in my way, and I haven't got the time today. Best you walk away, and live to fight another day.
What's going on, everybody on YouTube? This is your boy CC Simtex bringing you WGCW Kill Feed. Well, I guess this is kind of live on YouTube, but when you see it, it won't be. Anyway, for those of you who are wondering again why I have not live streamed this on Twitch TV, it is simply because YouTube seems to show more love to the WGCW community and shows, and I don't know. Twitch TV, I don't feel appreciated on Twitch TV. But anyways, I'm not here to rant, rave, and complain. I'm here to give you some ye olde wrestling. Ye olde wrestling. So without further ado, or don't, let's get this shit started. In mind, ladies and gentlemen, and since this is WGCW Kill Feed, you are going to see some rookies go at it against some of our upper echelon type of competitors, some people that are high up on the food chain. You'll see the franchise taking on and schooling a rookie and the fine arts of wrestling, as well as Vendetta. He'll do the same. And then we'll have some tag team competition as well, with the tag team champions to the chosen few, as they will be in non-title tag team action, also against a young up-and-comer. So that's what Kill Feed pretty much brings you. It brings you the youngest up-and-coming WGCW wrestlers. Let's go ahead and get this thing started. Mr. Ace Pullins making his way down to the ring. By the way, for Ace Pullings, the handler, for if you watch this, just know that before WGCW Breaking the Fourth Wall, you will have your theme song. I did not forget. I have it downloaded on my desktop. So I just want to point that out. Ace Pullings actually is a pretty phenomenal singles competitor so far in WGCW. He hasn't won a match yet, but I mean, let's be real. He took on a former Blaze heavyweight champion. So the performance he showed in that one match was off the chart. It was like a Shawn Michaels-like performance. See the fans here in the Killfeed Arena. They are up on their feet, excited for this matchup because everybody's a fan of Ace Bullings. With it, even though he does have that heel persona, you still gotta be a fan because of his performance. And he's taking on another former Blaze heavyweight champion, that being the Franchise, the second ever Blaze champion for WGCW. Man, a former hardcore champion, a former PCW tag team champion, former undisputed universal champion. So the Franchise is definitely among the top five when it comes to this Killfeed roster. We will see how he does taking on Ace Pulley. Vendetta took him on last, had an epic match with him, and now it's Franchise's turn to see if he can school the young rookie. This match is underway. Ace Bullings coming straight out the bat. We got the lights turned all the way up in this bitch. So if it is extremely bright, I do apologize. That's just the way the arena settings are. Beautiful swinging backdrop from Ace Bullings on the Franchise. Irish whip into the corner. And a stinger splash. And Ace Bullings looking pretty good in the early goings of this matchup. We're in a series of shots. That knife edge chop was countered, and now Franchise gonna try to get something going. As he counters out of the side headlock into a front face lock. Oh, and now working on the arm. Oh, look at this beautiful arm trap and neck breaker from Ace Pullings. Saw Franchise coming in a little over aggressively. And now again has control of this match. Franchise and Vendetta, they've been having some issues as of late with these rookies. Ace Pullings attacking Vendetta at the end of their last match, being a sore loser. I mean, he gave him an uppercut straight to the dick. So, you know. And then, I can't remember who it was that the Franchise was facing. I want to say it was Jonathan Walsh or Billy the Kid, one of the two. But either way, Franchise extended his hand out, you know, as a sign of respect. You know, great match, I enjoyed wrestling you. And that rookie just slapped his hand away and was like, fuck off. So it's been a great showing of disrespect towards some of the elite wrestlers on the WGCW Killfeed roster from these rookies. Franchise with an Irish whip now, and Charles Robinson would be wise to get the hell out the way. Otherwise, he'll be eating a boot in the face. Snapmare takeover. Oh, and a fish drop. Shades of the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. Senior, not junior. Dragon screw leg whip as Ace Pullings tries to regain control. Go behind waist lock. That's countered into a arm wringer right here. This is counter to the side headlock. Counter to the rear waist lock. Up and down with a backdrop from the Franchise. Great showing the chain grappling right there. And Franchise again with another beautiful backdrop. We're really working on the neck area of Ace Pulling, setting up that that Franchise bomb that he's known for. not mind that slight background music. I was actually on the WGCW website checking out the roster here, and you guys can actually do the same if you go to www.killfeedgaming.webs.com. Sign up and all that good stuff, and I will approve you. And then after that, you can check out the roster, check out the champions, check out the forums, and interact with your favorite WGCW superstars, and apply to become a WGCW superstar. So again, that's www.killfeedgaming.webs.com. Check it out. The website is being updated as this show goes on. Ace Pullings now with the franchise up on the top turnbuckle, setting up a high risk maneuver. Right hand to the face, going to the top turnbuckle. And superplex all the way down to the inside of the ring. Thank God he didn't do it to the outside, which we have seen many times before here in WGCW. Franchise somehow fighting his way back up to his feet. Went for the lariat, got caught with another arm trap and neck breaker. And Ace Pullings is looking pretty damn good in this matchup against a former World Heavyweight Champion. Now Franchise hanging up Ace Pullings' Tree of Woe position here. And from the Tree of Woe, he hits the Backstabber. I would go for the pin attempt right there, but instead Franchise working on the arm here. Not going for the pin after a huge move like that Backstabber, maybe showing some signs of frustration. And it may come back to haunt him here as he gets dropped with that sit-down neckbreaker. And now these elbows viciously being driven into the shoulder blades of the Franchise. Front face lock counter by the Franchise. Arm and collar tie up out here in the middle of the ring as Charles Robinson, our referee, watches on. Here we go with this great chain grappling between these two. Very technical. Counters the right hand and locks him in the abdominal stretch as referee Charles Robinson gets in position to check to see if Franchise will submit. And of course, he will not. We've never seen the Franchise submit before. Why would he now? Oh, go behind German suplex, spiking Ace Pullings down on his neck. And he's coming over here to my announcer. Hey, hey, asshole. Hey, hey. Stop throwing my TVs and monitors. Get your ass back in the ring. Oh, chop to the throat. And a kick right to the temple as the head of Ace Pullings hung off the apron. Referee only getting to a two count. Remember, WGCW uses the same count out rules as Ring of Honor. You get to the count of 20 because we think it's more entertaining that way, and Ring of Honor's way is more entertaining than WWE's way, so we're going to go with that. And great show of strength. Stalling vertical suplex. Franchise with a rake to the eyes of Ace Pullings, and now getting back out of the ring here. And this is that hardcore element that the Franchise has. Very comfortable with fighting in the ring or outside the ring. Oh, wait a minute! But he's about to be comfortably asleep on the outside as he just got dropped with the Diamond Cutter. The Franchise could be in some huge trouble here. He just took Ace Pullings' Ace Crusher, or the Diamond Cutter, call it what you want. Franchise busting him open on that steel ring post. Now Franchise with the count on the apron, forearm shot to the face, springboard, crossbody, and he took out the referee by mistake. Charles Robinson walked in the way mistakenly and got caught with the springboard crossbody. And that might have saved Ace Pullings for the moment. Irish whip into the corner. Stinger splash from Ace Pullings. Charles Robinson is back up on his feet. There's a rake of the eyes from the franchise. Snapmare takeover. And now the elbow right to the back of the head. Looked like Ace Pullings was about to go up top, but thought better of it. Irish whip over the top rope. And now vertical suplex back to the inside. Uh-oh. Ace Pullings is signaling the end here. And franchise could be in trouble. Irish whip countered. Into the ropes goes Ace. Oh, counter wraparound DDT. And the franchise has been busted open. Irish whip again over the top rope goes Ace Pullings. And kicked down to the floor on the outside. There's a body kick. And now franchise throwing him back in the ring. Again, chopped to the throat and a kick right to the temple as his head hang off the apron. Ace Pullings playing a little possum right there, though. Swinging backdrop. And now Ace Pullings looking to fly. Slingshot senton right across the gut. Hook of the leg. This might be it. One. No. Franchise kicking out. Irish whip countered by Franchise. Into the corner goes Ace Pullings. Now a shoulder thrust to the gut of Ace. And now he's getting put up on the top turnbuckle. And the Franchise looking to end this here. Top rope DDT! He just got planted. And that's got to be it. Franchise dragging his carcass out to the middle of the ring. Or away from the ropes. And only getting a one count as Ace was able to kick out. This has been an epic match between veteran versus rookie. And I told you, Ace Pullings is not to be... Wait a minute, one? Ace Pullings is not to be underestimated. Rookie or not, 0-1 in WGCW. But he has great showings, great performances against the best of the best in WGCW. And look at him just mocking the franchise, slapping him in the back of the head. And franchise got pissed off and had enough of that. Kick to the midsection. And there it is, the franchise bomb. And Ace was able to kick out before the referee could even get down for the count of one. You talk about adrenaline rush. Ace Pullings just took one of the most devastating moves. And look at this, he slaps him in the back of the head again and hits him with the German suplex after taking one of the most devastating moves in WGCW. Went for the slingshot senton from across the world and fell flat on his ass. And now the franchise is going to capitalize. Two clotheslines. He ducks one and catches Ace Pullings off the rebound. One. No, he kicks out of the power slam. Uh-oh. Spine buster, double A, Arn Anderson style, and that's got to be it right there. Lateral press, one, two, and three. That's it. Great showing from the franchise and Ace Pullings. As Ace Pullings comes up short yet again, ladies and gentlemen. 0-2, as he got a little too arrogant, went for a cross-the-world senton, and fell flat on his ass. And then he got spine busted on it. And the franchise picking up the victory. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. That's just the first match of the night. So don't go anywhere. Stay right where you are because there is going to be more to see coming up shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, we just witnessed an epic match between Ace Pullings and the franchise. Now, wait a minute. Oh, after the celebrating from the franchise, Ace Pullings just being a sore loser, spearing the franchise halfway to hell. What the hell was that about? See, that's what I'm talking about with these rookies showing this disrespect, man. They're showing this disrespect to the veterans, these former world champions. Instead of taking your loss like a man, you attack the man when he's not looking. That's no class. No class at all shown right there from Ace Pullings. While we get somebody to check on the franchise as we help him to the back here, we're going to get ready for our next match. This is just our second match coming up, ladies and gentlemen. Black Widow will take on King Mufa. Mufasa Fernando from Twitch TV being the handler of King Mufa, and ECG Crafty being the handler of Black Widow. Certainly hope King Mufa does not have arachnophobia, because he's going to have his hands full with this creepy looking arachnid motherfucker right here, Black Widow. Black Widow, actually one of our cruiserweights, and he's going to take on a heavyweight, but just because the size difference and the strength difference is noticeably different, do not count Black Widow out. Although this will not be an easy task for him in the least bit, but he can get the job done. He will face King Mufa as he makes his way out here to the ring. A five-time undisputed Universal Champion. So, it's going to be tough for Black Widow, I'm not going to lie. But he can get the job done. He does have the intangibles to out-wrestle King Mufa. He's going to have to force him to make a mistake, use his speed and agility to catch King Mufa off guard on a number of occasions to keep him down. As the Regal One comes out here in robe and crown, set to Mufa bomb his way to victory. Black Widow coming straight out the gate, running DDT on the King Mufa. King Mufa cutting that off real quick. Elbow right to the throat. For you WGCW Wednesday Night Reckless fans, if you watched our last upload onto YouTube, then you guys will know that Eli Leo, who was attacked by the Night Vamp right before their scheduled 3-on-2 handicap match, it was sanctioned to be Eli Leo and Scotty Starr, who is the Reckless World Heavyweight Champion, to take on Reviction, which was the team of KIA, King Roberts, and Mercer Crimson. However, Night Vamp attacked Eli Leo, so that match didn't happen, and ultimately turned out to be a gauntlet match between Scotty Starr taking on KIA, King Roberts, and Mercer Crimson. Now, KIA proving his worth to Reviction, as King Roberts and Mercer Crimson wasn't needed, and he caught Scotty Starr with the meanest super kick off of a springboard since Shawn Michaels versus Shelton Benjamin. Having said that, what Eli Leo will be facing up against next will be to get a little bit of payback, and that is Eli Leo next week on Reckless taking on the Night Vamp. Singles competition, cage match. That will be the main event for Wednesday Night Reckless next week. So it will go down. Mercer Crimson will take on Scotty Starr, and King Roberts and KIA will be in tag team action against MRA. Not MRA, excuse me. against Chosen Few. MRA, who are sanctioned to be the number one contenders for the tag team titles, they'll be watching on to see what Chosen Few does. Of course, that King Roberts Mercer Crimson's match is sanctioned to change. I might find something that might be more appealing to you, the fans, so I might roll with that. But as of right now, that's what we're looking at. But for sure, you will see Scotty Starr take on Mercer Crimson, and you will see KIA and King Roberts in tag team action of some kind. And then you will see for sure main event Night Vamp Eli Leo steel cage match. First person to exit the cage wins, and that's how we're going to do that. We're going to take pins and submissions and knockouts off. No referees will be needed for that bloodbath that that will ensue on Reckless. King Mufa, Black Widow, currently in the ring on Kill Feet, going at it. Dynamite J will be in action later on tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And if you didn't know, well, now you know. Dynamite J is the number one contender for Armageddon's Blazed World Heavyweight Championship. Jason Fury does have a rematch clause for that title. He lost his belt to Armageddon at WCW Aftermath, our WrestleMania. And Armageddon absolutely ran through him. I mean, it was like watching Sheamus versus Daniel Bryan at WrestleMania again. Armageddon just completely out-wrestling Jason Fury in that Hell in the Cell match. But they will have their rematch, but not until they might not have a rematch, because Jason Fury cannot use his rematch clause until after Dynamite J wrestles Armageddon at Breaking the Fourth Wall, which is in 2 weeks, pretty much. After this next Reckless, it'll be Breaking the Fourth Wall time. Look at this, as the Black Widow locks in the Rings of Saturn, give you guys another quick pay-per-view update after Breaking the Fourth Wall. There is no WGCW versus BWC this year, so I do apologize for those of you who wanted to see the cross-promotional phenomenon pay-per-view of E-Feds, where that's where normally we take the best 10 superstars from each E-Fed and we do battle. Cash Money, the chairman of WGCW, takes on the Extreme Omega Jax, who is the chairman and owner of BWC, and they normally put on the most epic of proportional freaking matches. I'm talking about Shawn Michaels versus Undertaker, The Rock versus Hulk Hogan, Macho Man versus Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, Kevin Steen versus Jay Briscoe. Those type matches. Michael Elgin versus Jay Lethal. Those type of matches happen at BWC versus WGCW. Sadly, though, that will not happen this year. Maybe on WWE 2K14, it will. But wait a minute. Let's get back to the action in the ring for a brief moment. Green Mist. Oh, and the Arachna Slam from Black Widow on the King Mufa. They spit that venom right in the face of King Mufa. And Mufa was able to kick out at the count of one, but you can see him favoring his head neck area as Black Widow has this match under control. Maybe not for long after taking a headbutt like that, but like I was saying, maybe it'll happen on WWE 2K14, but as of this year, it's not going to happen. So that puts us at Ruler of the Ring, which is our King of the Ring pay-per-view and tournament. There will be a challenge bracket for everybody to look at, same as last year. And that will start, I want to say, the pay-per-view should be mid-July. So, we still have Breaking the Fourth Wall. And then after that, we have four more weeks of WGCW Kill Feed and Reckless. As Black Widow busting open King Mufa right there with that Even Flow DDT. But within those 4 weeks, the tournament will be ongoing, and we will get down to the finals of the Ruler of the Ring match. So, plus there will be other matches too. There will be a tag team and all those great matches, King of the Cage matches. Oh, wait a minute, King Mufa with the Mufa bomb out of nowhere, just planting Black Widow, and that might be it. Lateral press one. No, Black Widow kicking out. Just under his adrenaline right there. And Black Widow actually has dealt out the most damage, even after taking the Mufa bomb. Has dealt out the most damage. And King Mufa is in trouble unless he's able to pull something off huge here. And I mean soon. Front face lock from King Mufa. Kick to the body, axe handle to the back, and a clothesline to the back of the head. Now King Mufa, out of desperation here, gonna try to pin, lateral press one, and does not hook the leg, and that's why he's not getting anything past the one. Beautiful drop toe hold counter. King Mufa with the side headlock, and that's countered. King Mufa with the running headbutt right to the chest. Now he drags him out to the middle of the ring. Lateral press, kick out before the count of one. Black Widow's not going to go down that easy. Arm and collar tie-up. Arm ringer from King Mufa. That's countered. Front face lock. That's countered. Side headlock. Oh, and a face crusher right there, or a knee crusher. Knee to face. And still, Black Widow able to hit these counters and still be in this match. He's favoring his rib area, going for the pin after the belly-to-belly. And only a one count, even with hooking the leg. There's an elbow right to the throat. And now stomping a mud hole in King Mufa and walking it dry. Uh-oh, Black Widow with a 110th Street Slam. That might be it for King Mufa. That might be it. Lateral press. One. No, he kicks out. King Mufa refusing to stay down. And King Mufa wisely getting out of the ring here, trying to buy himself some time, but Black Widow coming out after him. Black Widow going to work with these huge soup bone-like hands. Elbow to the throat. And a kick to the temple. And King Mufa again getting out of the ring. King Mufa's playing this very smart, and that's the veteranship showing. Oh, wait a minute! Green mist to the face! Go behind! Arachna Slam! He just hit that Arachna Slam again, but this time on the outside. And Black Widow, he's tired of playing games here. King Mufa wisely getting out of the ring after each high impact move to save himself, and he does it again. You can't get pinned on the inside or on the outside of the ring. It has to be on the inside. And King Mufa refusing to be in a position where he can get pinned, and you just got to respect that veteran quality that King Mufa is showing in this matchup. He's clearly being out wrestled, and he's doing everything he can to prevent from being pinned. And now Black Widow up on the coming over the top rope like he's Kane or somebody. Irish whip into the corner. Charles Robinson almost getting smashed. Double kicks to the chest. Running DDT out of the corner. Black Widow has King Mufa wearing the proverbial crimson mask. Hook of the leg. One. No, King Mufa still kicking out. But Black Widow is just out-wrestling King Mufa in every way possible. Into the corner goes Black Widow as he takes a shoulder thrust right to the gut. And now King Mufa drilling the face of Black Widow, but it's countered and thrown off across the ring. Look at these overhand rights and lefts. As King Mufa going right back to work in the corner. No, that's countered. Before he could land the first shot right there, he was countered. King Mufa with overhand right. Black Widow with a counter. Irish whip into the corner. Oh! Strong Irish whip, and now King Mufa saying this is going to be it. Oh! Kick to the gut. Black Widow cutting him off from that taunt here. King Mufa getting a little cocky, getting a little arrogant. Black Widow up on the top turnbuckle now. Kick to the chest. Kick to the chest. And he flies down with a missile dropkick. That might be it. That might be it. But Black Widow, rookie mistake, doesn't go for the pin. But he was able to hit the 110th Street Slam. Lateral press. One, two, three. Black Widow with the upset victory over the five-time former Universal Champion. Great match from Black Widow. And a huge upset as King Mufa continues his slump in WGCW. Congratulations to Black Widow. I told you, Black Widow has all the intangibles to beat some of the top talent of WGCW. It was just going to take him catching somebody off guard to do it. And that missile dropkick, I'm sure, caught King Mufa off guard, as well as both of those 110th Street Slams. Stay tuned, folks, because we do have more WGCW Kill Feed action coming up shortly. Again, while this loading is taking place, don't forget to check out the website, www.killfeedgaming.webs.com. And we are ready for some tag team action. As one half of the tag team champs is making his way down to the ring. Goodson! Yeah. Goodson and Cash Money, ladies and gentlemen, they will be defending these titles at Breaking the Fourth Wall. And they haven't been showing up as tag team champions. Championship material as of late. Their last two or three tag team matches they lost. As a matter of fact, I believe the last tag team match that they won was at WGCW Aftermath when they beat Cameron and Kip Smithers. But yeah, when they beat Cameron and Kip Smithers at WGCW Aftermath, which is an amazing match, by the way, and you can go and watch that on YouTube if you look down in the videos for WGCW Aftermath. That was the last time these guys won a tag team match, though. Here comes Cash Money. Cash Money actually has been, over the past few weeks, looking for somebody to help him run WGCW, because Cash Money is the owner and chairman of WGCW, but he wants to focus on his wrestling career, and he feels like he can't do that unless he can find some type of help. Now, we've seen him talking to people. We've even seen him talking to somebody actually at a WGCW event. We weren't able to see who it was, but we were able to see Cash Money talking to that person. So we're gonna find out. I hope by breaking the fourth wall or before then. Cash Money has to decide, either beat the chairman and retire from the ring, or step down and find this help that he's been looking for and continue his wrestling career. And that's what he's trying to do. The team of Chosen Few, Cash Money and Goodson, are set to take on somebody Cash Money knows very well. Harley Eastep, who is a former WGCW World Heavyweight Reckless Champion and has beaten Cash Money for that belt. I believe he's a three-time champion. Harley Eastep hasn't been able to do much, though, singles competition-wise. Last singles title was the King of the Cage champion, championship title, but that was, I believe, before WGCW Aftermath. I believe he lost at Battlegrounds the month before that, so he really hasn't been able to do much. His partner making his way down to the ring, Billy the freaking Kid. And this kid is such a show off. He's a new up and coming light heavyweight. And he thought he had Matthew Snowblade's number until he got planted on his freaking head with the frostbite. Now he's looking to do something in tag team competition. Billy the Kid coming out here with his super cool shades and his nice leather jacket. Ever the flamboyant one. And this kid literally thinks he can't be touched. I don't even think he's won yet. I think he's 0-2, but we'll see what he does. He has a world champion to mentor him throughout this match. But then again, Cash Money's a former six-time world champion in his own right, so we'll see what happens. As a matter of fact, Cash Money is a Grand Slam champion by Reckless roster standards, but Killfeed, he's never been the world champion. Whoo, and Goodson coming straight out the bat, calf kick, and Harley Eastep just got dropped. Too close to the ropes. Kick to the midsection, counter, dragon screw leg whip from Harley Eastep. Goodson with the front face lock, Irish whip into the hostile corner goes Harley Eastep. Tag made to Cash Money. And some double team action right here. Up and over, double back body drop. Now Cash Money stomping out the limbs of Harley Eastep here as Chosen Few is all business here tonight. Springboard Lion Salt. Cash Money is all over Harley Eastep. Oh, but runs right into a hip toss. And Billy the Kid already wants to be tagged in. Cash Money arm trap and neck breaker. Again, Cash Money arm trap and neck breakers. Harley Eastep being a little too aggressive. Chipping up already. Oh, forearm to the face. Manhattan drop. Up and down with the scoop slam on Cash Money. And Harley Eastep just coming out of nowhere with the comeback. And a drop kick taking Cash Money down. Up and over, exploder suplex. Cash Money could be in trouble here early. One. No, he kicks out. Huge exploder suplex. And now Harley makes the tag to Billy the Kid. Cash Money with the front face lock winning that exchange. and T-bone suplex. Oh, Cash just got a right hook right to the jaw. Oh, and spear to Harley as he knocks him off the apron and sends him flying into the steel barrier. And now Cash Money with the back elbow to the face. Cash Money and Goodson choosing to wrestle a more freelance type of style of wrestling. More of a Ring of Honor style, I guess you could say. They don't have any restrictions for what they do. They fly around, they use submissions, and they're very technical. And Goodson getting tagged in as Cash Money was getting a little work there. Goodson elbow right to the throat. Goodson the master of the snapmare driver. He'll break your freaking neck. And now look at this, Dragon Sleeper locked in and applied. Billy the Kid getting strangled and choked out here, but able to fight his way out of the submission. Go behind, German suplex. And now look at this, Fujiwara armbar, just what I was talking about. Not afraid to go to the submission game if they need to. And now Billy the Kid, wait a minute, Billy the Kid just hit the that cradle face buster. Hook of the leg, one. And Goodson was able to get the shoulder up. That's Billy the Kid's finishing move, and Goodson was able to kick out, and Cash Money didn't even bother to get in the ring to try to help him. I think he just knew he had it under control. Calf kick ducked by Billy the Kid. He hits the right hand. Up and down with the backdrop. Billy the Kid and Harley Eastep are actually looking pretty decent against the Chosen Few here. Goodson's in this hostile territory. Guys chain grapple. Irish whip, pull back, neck breaker from Billy the Kid. As the Kid looks to pick up his first win here. Getting out of the ring and coming over to my announcer table. Come on, man. We just put those monitors and that top back on here. And look at this. Billy the Kid just wanted to bait Goodson outside. And he used that opportunity to take advantage and elbow him right in the throat. And Harley Eastep trying to distract Goodson. And now look at this two-on-one situation over here on the hostile side of the ring for Goodson. Into the barricade goes Goodson. Now Goodson thrown into the steel ring post. Slammed into it face first and then thrown back into the ring. Tag made to Cash Money. Slingshot cross body, and it was more like a slingshot left hand because that's all that hit him. Billy the Kid with a rake to the eyes. Billy the Kid and Harley Eastep are looking pretty damn good against the tag team champions right now. Tag made to Harley. And a kick right to the body. Cash Money and Harley Eastep back at it in this match for the second time. I'd say Harley Eastep won the first exchange. Cash Money, arm ringer, or arm trap and neck breaker. Springboard, moonsault, and even hooked the leg. Went for the pin that time, but only got a one count. Going for the pin again, one, and just another one count. Cash Money being very smart and going for these pin attempts. Open hand slaps, three piece. Pull back, belly to belly suplex. Oh, spinning back fist. Shades of Michael Elgin. Harley Eastep with the spinning back fist. And now look at this. Billy the Kid cutting off Cash Money. And Cash Money kipping up but getting planted with the DDT. This is not looking good for Cash. Spinning back kick to the gut, though. Irish whip. Catches him with a calf kick. Catches him with another. Traps the arm. Hits the neck breaker. One of Cash Money's favorite moves right there. Hook of the leg, one. And he kicks out. And now Cash Money. Oh, he could have been setting up that Omega Driver. If he would have hit that Omega Driver, it would have been curtains for Billy the Kid. Cash Money fighting his way back up to his feet. Tag made to Goodson. Goodson gets caught in the side headlock as soon as he gets in the ring. Irish whip into the corner. Tag made to Harley. And a kick to the body of Goodson. Oh, Goodson went for the snapmare driver, but Harley saw it coming. Hit the code breaker. The code breaker just planted Goodson, and Goodson just kipped up. Manhattan drop on the Goodson. Arm wringer and a takedown. Hook of the leg, one. Goodson's going to kick out of that. Uh-oh. Goodson with a series of clotheslines. Tilt the World Slam. Can Goodson pull it off here for Team Chosen Few? Hook of the leg, one. He kicks out. And Goodson cutting off Harley and preventing him from making a tag. Tag made to Cash Money, and Harley Eastep wants no part of that. Tag made to Billy the Kid. And Billy the Kid wants no part of that either as he gets out the ring. Billy the Kid has done a good job of baiting Cash Money and Goodson out into this hostile territory. And now the two-on-one will commence out here by me and the announcer. Hey, get away from me. Look at that. Harley Eastep throwing Cash Money back into the ring. Cash Money favoring that rib area. And Cash Money coming right back out after him, as he is not afraid of this two-on-one situation. And maybe he should be, because he is getting jumped. Cash Money with a counter. Harley Eastep with a counter. Chain grappling on the outside. And Harley throws him back into the ring. Gives him an elbow right to the throat. His head hung off the apron. And the team of Chosen Few could be in freaking trouble here. Oh! Mean elbow right to the face. Slingshot body press, and Harley was able to roll out of the way. Oh, and here comes Goodson. He's seen enough. Cash Money back up on his feet. Takes Harley off the apron. And then takes a series of right hands. Kick to the chest. Irish whip over the top. And down to the outside goes Cash Money again in the hostile area. It is not looking good for Cash Money and Goodson right now. Oh, wait a minute. Cash Money holding his own here as he sends Billy the Kid into the steel ring post. And Cash Money with the counter. Irish whip. Arm trap and neck breaker. Tag made to Goodson. I want to say he's the fresh man, but... Oh, Cash Money just got speared into that barricade. Goodson going right out after Billy the Kid. Throwing him back into the ring here, as these guys are going to look for the finish. Goodson taking his time here. He needs to get in the ring. Harley's going to help him. Nice showing the teamwork there from Billy the Kid. And Harley Eastep. Tag made back to Cash Money. Kick to the midsection from Cash. Side headlock. Irish whip into the corner. Oh, look at Billy the Kid with a counter. Getting out of the precarious situation. Putting Cash up on the top turnbuckle. Frankensteiner? No. Double underhook suplex down to the inside of the ring. He should have went for the pin, but opted not to. I don't know why. And now Cash Money kicked to the midsection. Back elbow to the face. Oh, wait a minute. Cash Money saying that this is it. Oh, he just planted Billy the Kid. Billy the Kid just got planted. Hook of the leg. One. No, he was able to get the shoulder up. Swinging back suplex. And now Cash Money getting thrown over the top, but hanging on. But not for long. He's kicked down to the floor. And Harley Eastep has been tagged in. Cash Money getting back in the ring. Open hand slap. Irish whip into the corner. And he fights his way out. Preventing the double team attack. Cash Money with a counter right here. Pullback belly to belly suplex from Cash. And now springboard from across the ring. Hook of the leg. One. No. He kicks out. Hook of the leg again. One. And he kicks out again. And Cash Money makes the tag. Goodson with a shoryuken right to the jaw. Get your ass off the apron, Billy. Goodson looking to set up the finish, but they exchange hands. Goodson came in on fire. Oh, no. That's gonna be it for Goodson as he got hit with a code breaker. One, two, and three. Harley Eastep just helped Billy the Kid get his first win over Cash Money and Goodson. And Goodson's bleeding out a lot. Goodson has lost a lot of blood. Cash Money and Goodson just can't seem to get the ball rolling when it comes to tag team competition. They just can't seem to do it. They have lost about four straight. And the tag team champions are going to be in some serious trouble regardless of who they face, whether it be MRA or whether it be Reviction. They're going to be in some serious freaking trouble. We are getting set, ladies and gentlemen, for one of our two main events. Vendetta will take on the young rookie, JC Castro, who is an amazing rookie, and I believe so far he's undefeated. Stars break fall. Vendetta, ladies and gentlemen, the first ever Blazed Heavyweight Champion. And for those of you that don't know, that is the world title for Killfeed. Vendetta actually winning that title is pretty huge, considering that him and Dr. Blaze are really good friends, of course, outside of the ring. And the 1 year death anniversary of Dr. Blaze, who the title was named after, was this past May 28th, and there will be a special tribute show for Dr. Blaze at Breaking the Fourth Wall. That will be a special Dr. Blaze tribute. And I hope you all will subscribe. Tell your friends about WGCW, as we are on YouTube every week, so you guys can watch all the cool WGCW action and things of that nature. But right now, JC Castro, who I believe is undefeated, is going to take on the first ever Blazed Heavyweight Champion, Vendetta. And it's going to be pretty interesting to see what this rookie can do against a former world champion. And look at this, Vendetta straight out the bat. Multiple backdrops. No, and then a German suplex. Beautiful move right there. That's how a champion starts off a match. Vendetta catching the kick. Dragon screw leg whip. Falling headbutt, but just a grazing shot. Oh, look at these series of kicks from JC Castro. Vendetta pull back, belly-to-belly suplex. We just saw the tag team champions. We just saw the tag team champions lose to Harley Eastep and the rookie Billy the Kid. Look at the flapjack into Samoan drop. Head scissor takedown. Great show of athleticism, and that's what JC Castro is going to have to do. Oof, and that head kick. He's going to have to use his speed and apparently his tremendous striking ability to outmaneuver and outstrike Vendetta, as he just hit him with the K2 face buster. And now, here comes a series of strikes here from Vendetta, who's no stranger to kicks himself. Vicious head kick right there. Arm wringer now. Front face lock countered. Go behind waist lock. Counter to the side headlock. Oh, and here we go with the strikes again. Series of kicks right to that left leg. Oh, he caught one kick but didn't catch the other. Beautiful enziguri from JC Castro. And K2 face buster again from Vendetta. Rings of Saturn submission locked in, but JC Castro able to find a way out of it. But can he find his way out of this? This Christo submission hold, or I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I don't know if it's Christo or Christo. But regardless, it does a lot of damage to the neck and arms. And now the Rings of Saturn, which does the same thing. Swing and a miss with the calf kick by Vendetta right there. Oh, that running super kick almost knocked the face off of Vendetta. Beautiful shining wizard from Vendetta. There's another vicious head kick, JC Castro. And again, I do apologize for this match if I have slowed down a bit on the commentary. It's just, I am kind of updating the website at the same time as doing the show, which is why this is live but not live. It's live when I do it, but it's not live when you see it. Vendetta going to work again with the double back drops. Both of those connect. And the German suplex does too. There's another one of those head kicks. And now Castro baiting in Vendetta. Kicks him right in the face. Kick to the midsection now. Irish whip. Oh, look at this. Vendetta catching that kick. And now getting outside of the ring here. Come on, man. We've done good tonight without losing this table. Every time we put these monitors back in the goddamn table, somebody gotta... Listen, assholes. Leave our monitors and our tables alone. Go behind calf kick from JC Castro. Get him, Castro. Throw him back in the ring. Get him away from my table. Ooh. Running super kick on the outside. That might have put Vendetta to sleep. Ooh. Another head kick. Castro's kicking the shit out of Alejandro Vendetta. Oh, no. Come on. Come on. Come on. No. 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 I didn't even get to move my laptop. No. What are you doing? Oh, my God. He's dead! He fucking killed him! He fucking killed him! Oh my God! I thought it was gonna be reversed. He was gonna backdrop him off the table. And he hit him with the flipping fucking pile driver straight through the fucking announcer table and busted him open. Vendetta just killed this young rookie. He killed him. The referee is counting him out. I don't think JC Castro's getting up ever again. I think he died. Oh my fucking... We need EMTs. We need EMTs. We need some type of medical attention. If you're a nurse in the damn audience, get your bitch ass over the rail and give some CPR or something. This man is dead. And Vendetta knows that too, as he signaled that that was the end. That was it for this rookie. He will suffer his first loss. And his first loss required him to die. The referee said, nope, fuck this, we're throwing this out. No need to count this anymore. Vendetta has crushed JC Castro. And he's about to knock out the fucking ref. I think Vendetta has had it with these rookies. Along with Franchise. I I mean, I get, congratulations, I guess, to Vendetta for the win, but he might have killed this man. We're going to need some medical attention for JC Grimaldo. We're going to see if we can get a stretcher out here. Not JC Grimaldo, JC Castro, excuse me. We're going to need to get a stretcher or something out here and see if we can help him. Might be too late. I think rigor is setting in. Let's see if we can get the stretcher out here. Anybody? Medical attention, EMTs, anybody backstage? You want to stop eating donuts for a minute and get your fat asses out here? We got a man out here that's fucked up. And what the hell is this? Vendetta throwing him back in the ring and he's not done with that. And look at where the franchise come from. Franchise coming from out of what are they doing? What are they doing? Oh! What the fuck is wrong with you people? The veterans have made a statement as they just clocked JC Castro from each side with steel chairs after he just got planted with that flip pile driver through the announcer table. I mean, what the hell's going on? These guys are showing no type of concern for this man's bodily well-being. I mean,
do you smell what the Rock is cooking?
Oh, wait a minute. Now Chosen Few are out here after suffering that loss earlier. They're talking like they didn't just lose. Yes, don't mind the typo. Chosen Few. Putting MRA and Reviction on notice. How can you put somebody on notice? You lost four straight. Wait a minute. Jason Fury, I do apologize for the game glitch. That is Jason Fury talking, not Cash Money. It's flipped for some reason. Cash Money pretty much done. Jason Fury, he will have no problem getting his title shot once his management help arrives. Jason Fury, as he talks to Cash Money, he better go and get warmed up for this main event. Triple threat non-title match, ladies and gentlemen. The number one contender that will take on Armageddon at Breaking the Fourth Wall. Dynamite J will be in a triple threat match against Armageddon, who is the Blaze World Heavyweight Champion, and Jason Fury, who you just seen talking with Cash Money. Franchise and Vendetta have lost their freaking minds. We're getting our announcer, a different announcer table. We had to commandeer the Spanish announce table. So I'm sorry, but this is ours now, so I don't know what to tell anybody else. But it's okay. If this one gets broken, the German announce table will be commandeered as well.
Double OT, nigga, that's me. Low key, don't talk to the police. Run round in the city in a two-seat. So, nigga, hasta la vista. Never love on my fork, I'ma leave him. On occasion, I'm flipping tequila. Got my stripes like the Medea. Ha! You them niggas, huh? Real nigga, what? Getting money, what? Can't get enough. In a two-go, with two hoes. Send two hat. That's Pluto. Won't your chick?
Jason Fury, who was a long-time double champion. He was a Pure Impact champion. And he was also the Blaze Heavyweight Champion for a long time. Lost both of those titles. He lost his Pure Impact Championship to Leonardo Nixon. And as stated already many times before, He lost the Blaze Championship to this man, Armageddon.
Jump on dick ass nigga. Bet your mom rent be your best friend when this F ain't blast hit ya. Got a big money grip and a big booty bitch. I'ma twist a thick ass swisher. Hit ya, get comatose on that California dope. One night burning up so dope. This game got throw another dose. And this in my overcoat. Slamming in the second dick. When I'm in your town, I shut me down like I'm the president. The motherfucking president. President. Bitch, I'm out for president. Bound to cut me down like I'm the motherfucking president. The president. Bitch, I'm out for precedence. When I'm in the town, we shut it down like I'm the president. Bitch ass nigga, I won't kiss ass bitch. Hope you mob with the squad.
That is the Kill Feed World Champion right there, the Blaze Champion, Armageddon.
Bitch, we made in that mid. They slamming quick gates running. We took.
I do appreciate everybody who has watched WGCW up to this point. We are an hour and 17 minutes in, which is our norm for every show. Unless it's a pay-per-view. Now, Breaking the Fourth Wall will be done on Twitch TV Live. So, if you look down in the description box, you can see my live stream, which is live every day also. Whether I'm playing League of Legends, Call of Duty, Madden, NBA, it doesn't really matter. WWE sometimes, it doesn't really matter. It is going to be... But that's cool. I got shows getting money, I could barely afford. Live on Twitch TV. You can check me out every day up until then. Just to give you guys an exact date of WCW Breaking the Fourth Wall. It will be June 16th for Breaking the Fourth Wall. And this match is underway. In case anybody is wondering about the attire, I just want to point out that it's supposed to be like that. It's supposed to be a light effect. You know, like when Jeff Hardy comes out and he's really wearing all white, but he's glowing like some type of bluish, purplish, pink color. Yeah, that's what that was meant to be. So, at least when he was in WWE. So, having said that, we're going to move on with this matchup, just so I can explain that to people who are like, hey, wait a minute, this guy's a phony. He was wearing turquoise a second ago, and now he's wearing red. So yeah, just pointing that out. This is an awesome attire from all of these guys. Dynamite J is being my favorite attire in this match. And he's going to play this smart here as Armageddon and Jason Fury go at it with one another. But Jason Fury just knocked the 7 foot, 358 pound monster over the top rope and down to the outside. And Armageddon just kind of shrugs it off. Laughs it off a little bit. Dynamite J takes a snap suplex from Jason Fury. And now look at this. Double team from Armageddon and Jason Fury on Dynamite J. Double gut buster. This is our main event of the night. So I hope you guys have enjoyed the show up to this point. Comment in the comment box down below. And let me know what you thought the best match of the night was by far. I mean, even just... For me, so far, it's Ace Pullings versus the franchise. That match was just off the chain. So let me know what you guys think here. And beautiful black hole slam from Armageddon. Also, feel free to subscribe so you can catch videos from me every single week. WGCW Super Mario. But speaking of which, Super Mario World 2 on the Wii, New Super Mario Brothers Wii, that will be posted up also either tomorrow, in the next few days, either tomorrow or what's today? Today's Wednesday, but no, today's Thursday. So either tomorrow or Saturday morning. So look out for that. Now Dynamite J putting Jay Superior up on the top turnbuckle and going for something high risk, maybe? For the second rope, super fallaway slam. Looked like he was going to try to set him up for the camel clutch, but Jason Fury was able to push him away and get his distance. Looks like Armageddon and Dynamite J have their sights focused on Jason Fury. As they hit a double team gut buster on him, Fury and Armageddon hit it on Dynamite J. And now Jay and Armageddon hit it on Fury. Beautiful wraparound DDT. Belly to belly suplex from Armageddon. Now the big man going down to the outside. Come on, come on. This is the Spanish announce table we're using, and we're nice enough to let us use it. Kimura just took the top off of it, and Rings of Saturn locked in on Jason Fury. Will he submit? He's stretching him out pretty good. Will he submit? No, he actually was able to hang on long enough to fight his way out. Jason Fury with a counter right there, but unaware of Dynamite J being behind him. And the final cut getting dropped onto Jason Fury. And now a Regal Plex. Oh, hook of the leg going for the pin. Dropping Fury right down on his neck. And Fury is favoring the rib area. This has been a double team onslaught. As the electric chair drop is not going to help those ribs out in the least bit. Front face lock. Wait a minute, double team. Oh! Jumping calf kick. That looked like some Harlem Heat right there. Dragon screw leg whip from Fury. Single leg takedown. Jason Fury and Armageddon going at it. Dynamite J buying his time, just watching and waiting. Doing a very good job of not getting too involved, not getting exhausted, and tiring himself out doing extra stuff. Let these two knock each other the hell out and then just slide in for the pin. Beautiful belly-to-belly suplex, and that's the moments you want to come in at. When he's down or groggy, come in then. And now, Armageddon was looking at Dynamite J for a brief second after Jason Fury hit him with that elbow right to the face in the corner. Look at the strength, 350-pound suplex. And just as Jason Fury starts to get something going, he's cut off with the throwback face buster. He's turning his attention to both men right here because he has to. It's been a double team onslaught for the most part of this match. Jason Fury, He's a guy that won't say, that'll never say he quits. He won't say die. He's a fighter. And he'll take on two or three guys if he has to. Right now, he kind of has to. Irish whip it, countered by Dynamite J. They both knock heads and collide. Fury went for that Fury Breaker. He went for the Fury Breaker, one of his finishing moves, but was countered. Flashback, sleeper hold, neck breaker, call it what you want. Oh, beautiful flipping senton on to Armageddon. Armageddon looked like he was going to set up Dynamite J after he fought his way back up to his feet, but it's cut off, knee to the face. Irish whip over the top rope and kick down to the floor on the outside. And now they're out here in front of our announcer table again, the Spanish announcer table. We're going to run out of tables if these guys don't quit. Oh, wait a minute. Armageddon countering two finishers here. And now Jason Fury getting put up on top of the table here. What's Dynamite J doing? Oh, no, counter! Jason Fury with the counter! And a DDT! Huge DDT counter! And ladies and gentlemen, remember in the main events, there is no count out. There is no count out in a WGCW main event. It looked like Dynamite J was going to put Fury through the table. Fury was able to counter and even flow him right through it. Uh-oh. And look at that. Armageddon just saved Jason Fury from getting DDT'd. There's a sit-out twisting neck breaker. Dynamite J kipping up. Knee breaker right there. Uh-oh. Armageddon signaling the end. Spinning back fist to the face. Up and down with the fisherman DDT. And look at this. Look at the leg from Dynamite J. To the corner, and Fury was able to sidestep the spear, flipping senton in the corner, shades of Kevin Steen. And now the surfboard stretch is locked in on Armageddon. With the massive upper body strength of Armageddon, easily just throwing Jason Fury over him. Up and down with that electric chair drop. Uh-oh. Armageddon setting him up again. Fury fighting away, back elbows to the face. And now a double team. Oh! That calf kick. Shades of Harlem Heat one. And Jason Fury able to kick out. I don't know how he's continuing to fight on in this matchup. Jason Fury has taken, obviously, the most damage. His ribs are killing him. Armageddon and Dynamite J look fine, pretty much. But somehow, Jason Fury still is fighting through this. Look at this counter. Arm wringer. That's counter to the side headlock. And then knee right to the face of Jason Fury. And now Dynamite J actually going after Armageddon, as Jason Fury's on Dream Street. Oh, black hole slam. Dynamite J just ran right into that. And Armageddon getting tired of Dynamite J, but Fury cutting him off. Wrap around DDT. Standing shooting star press from Dynamite J, and another one, two of them. Wrap around DDT again on Dynamite J. Shot to the body. Look at that. Armageddon getting cut off as he was charging right after Dynamite J. Snapmare takeover. Jason Fury. Side Russian leg sweep on the champion. Irish whip, pull back, and kitchen sink. Uh-oh. Dynamite J with that swinging neck breaker, hook of the leg, and just a one count. It's Armageddon now favoring his rib area. Nice counter from Jason Fury. Oh my god! Reverse fucking Frankensteiner! And that might have just knocked out, or could have broken the neck, really. Oh, Dynamite J was going for the flip pile driver. Fury cut him off, and now Armageddon going to work series of clotheslines. Oh, wait a minute! Oh! Swiss death! Dynamite J picked his spot, and he hit it! 1, 2, 3! Dynamite J has just pinned the champion, and Armageddon is eliminated. It is down to Jason Fury and Dynamite J. And Dynamite J just sending a message to Armageddon in this triple threat elimination match. He just pinned him and sent him packing first. So now, not only does he have to go to the back with a loss, you know, under his belt, but he has to watch these two continue to battle it out here so he can study his opponent, the Dynamite J. Oh, wait a minute. Fury Breaker! Fury Breaker! Jason Fury just planted him with the Fury Breaker. Hook of the leg. Can he get him? One! Now he kicks out. Shot to the body. I don't know how Dynamite J mustered up the strength to even lift Armageddon up that high and hit him with that Swiss death. Double to the throat. One. Oh, he kicks out. Jason Fury getting desperate here to show why he wants that number one, or that his title shot sooner than later. Full backbreaker. Roderick Strong style. Oh, wait a minute. Trap the arm. Kick to the midsection. Hook of the arms. Pedigree. 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 He's going to do it. Hook of the leg. One. No. How is Dynamite J kicking out of all of this? Jason Fury has hit him with the best that he has. That Fury Breaker and the Pedigree. Beautiful counter arm drag. Hook of the leg. One, two, three. He's gonna beat him. Use that momentum against him with the counter arm drag after that devastating Fury Breaker and that Pedigree. And I think that's really what did in Dynamite J. I think he was just fighting off of adrenaline, and that Armageddon, or that arm drag just caused the adrenaline to run out. Jason Fury, not with the greatest of finishes, but pretty flashy counter from a flying clothesline into a pretty devastating arm drag. But regardless of the finish, he got the job done. Jason Fury waiting to invoke his rematch clause, ladies and gentlemen, for that Blaze World Heavyweight Championship. He wants to be back on top of the mountain. And he's going to do anything and beat anybody to get there. Jason Fury has actually been on an absolute terror since losing both his titles, the Pure Impact and the Blaze Championship. But I want to thank everybody for watching WGCW Kill Feed. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you next time. This has been your host, CC Simtex. And after an hour and 35 minutes of epic wrestling, we will see you next week. Peace. I like to play it real loud. I like to drive with the top down, rolling out.